Hey, what is up everybody? Jason here. Today we are taking a look at my latest Mindstorms robot. If you have been following me for a while, you know that it is a tradition in the JK Brickworks household to build a machine to help deliver treats to the kids that come to our door every Halloween. And this year I finally decided to tackle these mini bags of potato chips that are popular to give out here in Canada. And they come in a variety of different brands, but I just happened to pick up a box of these Lay's ones. Before we dive into the details, I have put together building instructions for this model. They are freely available over at jkbrickworks.com. Even if you don't have these mini chip bags, I'm sure you can find other ways to have fun with this machine. And this model is built entirely using pieces from the latest Mindstorms robot inventor kit. So if you have this set, you can build it. So how does it work? As you saw in the introduction, it consists of a robotic arm that goes and picks up a bag of chips from the back and brings it to the front. And it is a pretty typical robot arm design. This motor drives this 12-tooth gear underneath, which meshes with this 36-tooth gear, which is just rigidly connected to the base, so that as that 12-tooth gear rotates, the entire arm assembly rotates around that 36-tooth gear. The next motor controls the height of the main arm, and it rotates these control arms to raise and lower the front of the arm, which is anchored to the frame at the back here. And this motor opens and closes the grabber by rotating these two meshed 24-tooth gears. And I'm just using these soft rubber connectors that come in the set to actually grab the bags. The control hub is at the back of the arm, along with these wheels, which just act as a counterweight for the arm, so that the arm is roughly balanced around the pivot point. And this just makes it so the motor controlling the height of the arm doesn't have to work too hard to lift the chip bags. Since the grabbing mechanism can already move around, I decided to just go with a static reservoir of chip bags in the back. And they're arranged in an arc matching the curve that the arm makes. To know when to stop, I'm using the ultrasonic sensor here in the front so that it will just rotate until it detects a bag, then pick it up. So as the bags are removed, it will just keep rotating on to the next one. I'm also using the light sensor mounted at the base of the arm assembly here to detect these red pieces, so that the arm knows when to stop when it rotates back to the front to deliver the bag of chips. And the ultrasonic sensor is also used to start the entire process, so the kids can either wave their hand in front of the machine or hold their bag up to it to have it go get a bag of chips for them. Along with the instructions, you can also find the program file and notes on how to wire it up over on my website. And that is pretty much it for this one. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you in the next one.